Hey, give it up for White Denim. Holy moly, what a bunch of freakishly good musicians. They make us look like novices.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Friday. Welcome to the MAHA State. Just listening to a little Tame Impala. Love this song, Glass Half Full. Check it out. It is on the live versions of Tame Impala on the Spotify, and you can check us out on our Spotify playlist at MAHA Wines. We're setting something up every week while we do this. Beautiful day here at the MAHA. We're not too backlit. You can see the vineyard in the background. White dogs are wandering around. Let me turn the music down more-ish. How's that? Can you guys hear us?
And can you see us? Are we too backlit? It's kind of hard to tell.
Backlit. I don't know about backlit. I'm just lit. No, I'm not lit.
I guess I need to catch up.
So, thanks for tuning in this afternoon.
Yes.
We are, we're going over, the wines of the MAHA estate, and, we're happy that you're here to, join us. So, a little backstory on the wines. Behind us is the MAHA estate. It's a 60-acre parcel that we planted in 2000. And let me step back. We purchased it in 2003. We dropped our modular home. We built the winery in 06. Planted the vineyard in 2012 and 13. And we've been farming organically and biodynamically since day one and received certification in 2015. So we're super excited to present these wines today. It's... there are three wines off property, a white wine, textural and age-worthy, and then two red wines, which we'll get to in a moment. They're based on yin and yang. So why don't we start off with the first white wine, which is before anyone else. Joanne?
So last week, I think I mentioned that this is my favorite wine that we've got going on right now. Who has a bottle open?
I do.
Even if you don't, we'll try to tell you all about it. So it's Claret, 100% Claret. The name before anyone else is kind of a reference to the sun. This is a very sunny...
A Vieuvine 100% Claret that's pretty banging. She ages in all new big barrel. If you can find it, try it. It's delicious. And then the other one would be Louis Barul from Gigandas Chateau de Saint-Côme, and his wine is called Le Post Blanc. So this is a great wine, textural, yummy. It's got good cut. Still got a lot of nerve.
I've got a lot of nerve. Well, Jeff Newton was inspirational in our planting of Claret, because we were walking the vineyard with him. Jeff Newton is a rock star consultant, vineyard consultant down in Santa Barbara County, and he was getting something going up here in Paso when we were planting, which was very fortuitous for that word is for us. We were walking around. We have kind of a a dip in the property, one of our lower spots, and he thought this would be a great place for claret. And so that is kind of where the light bulb went off, and we're super excited to have it. We love we're gonna have some Roussan here.
Oh my gosh, we should plant
pretty
some.
Soon also.
Yeah.
And so that'll be exciting too, but for now we have claret and it's delicious and we're really happy with how it's
look, we've got all kinds of fun people in the house, don't we? We got Juan Mercado,
we
got
some Maronis.
The Maronis, we've got Mari.
Pat and Olivia. I didn't say hi to you last time, but I saw that you were here.
So delicious. If you haven't had it, you should. If there isn't any in your cellar, you should have it in your cellar.
Chris, how would you describe the claret here?
Oh, nice stem. What a nice stem you have,
Joy. Oh, what kind is that?
I believe it's a Sophienwald. Oh, yeah, Sophienwald. Joanne's using the... We've decided that we've partnered up with Sophienwald. They're out of Switzerland. Great stemware, super nice. Nice, light, fine.
For those of you who only drink out of Zaltos, you might like the stem better. Just saying.
We do. I like kind of the... It's a bit of nuts. It's got apricots and nuts to it. Nice texture. What do you got? That's all I got right now.
I got that...
oh my God.
I really love the mouthfeel. It's kind of medium-bodied. It's not... it's not too light and snappy, but it's also not like rich and syrupy like, say, Viognier can be. It's a really nice medium-bodied wine that's got... It's really hard to pinpoint the flavor components because it's very... some days can taste kind of citrusy or like orange blossoms or honey.
Wines is based on a yin and a yang. A fruit and a savory, a masculine and a feminine, a his and a hers. What we've really enjoyed with this wine is these wines is different people pull different things. So what I would consider to be maybe fruity and masculine, kind of like you, Artie, Juan would say no, he's not fruity and masculine. He's kind of savory and delicate. So the fun thing about wine is it's so subjective. So understory, which Joanne has in her glass, a little lighter in color, more Grenache based, a little more structure is I don't know if it has more or less structure. It's kind of dependent upon the drinker. Oh, I get finesse. Do you get finesse? I get rat fur.
Well, do you have the same wine?
I have a different wine. Look at the
look
at the color. Thing. Look at the legs.
Well, we've got like definitely you can see the Petite Sirah, and the Grenache is usually a little lighter, brighter, a little more ruby red, beautiful. So one really cool thing about the Maha is that we're situated in a totally unique location in Paso. We're actually right on the cusp of the Willow Creek Appalachian and the Adelaida District. So we're in this canyon all by ourselves. Well, actually, we have a new neighbor, Jay Lore. But our elevation is also a little higher. We're 1,200 to 1,800 feet in elevation. So we kind of sit above the fog line. We can see the fog rolling in. We can feel the ocean breezes. And occasionally we do get the fog, but it just keeps everything really perfect. So we're not as hot as, say, somebody that's over the hill, a mile closer to town even, because we're on this ocean side of the ridge. So what does that bring to the wine, Chris?
Well, I think what we're finding out here at the Maha is there's a tremendous amount of energy in the fruit. a lot of electricity. One of our challenges, and then a lot of the challenge on the west side of Paso compared to other regions in California is we've got lots of our high alkaline soils, our coastal influence. We have we can create nice, rich, plush wines that have really great acidity and freshness. Here, as we're learning this site, we've got a lot of acid, and how we mitigate that to create a wine that's texturally pleasing is fun. I mean, it can be a challenge. We have Syrah coming online this year. So here at the MAHA Estate, we have Grenache, Carignan, Petite Syrah, initially planted Graciano as Monastrell, Mourvèdre, and Claret. So we are not fans of the Graciano here at this site, though it works well in a lot of spots in Paso. So we grafted over an acre of that to a Massal selection of Syrah. So basically Massal is multiple clones within the same block. So those were cuttings from James Berry Vineyard and from Lunamata Vineyard. I think the clones are 470 and some Bone Rock. No, not Bone Rock, that's the next one. And some 174. Actually, that's Denner and Lunamata. We're gonna graft over the other half acre. We're gonna graft over some Carignan to some Syrah. That's all off of James Berry cuttings. And then we're gonna take the other half acre of Graciano and graft it over to Roussan, which comes from our friends over the hill at Adelaida Cellars. They've got a nice clean nursery block of Roussan. So it really is all about creating balanced wine with good fruit, good texture, good acid, and great energy.
I'm going to get a visual aid.
Where's our whale bone?
Did you say whale bone?
Yeah.
That's up the street.
No, it's not. It's right here.
Oh, it's right here.
So, just a word about the soil. This is a whale vertebrae that we found, Henry Cherry, our son, found on the property. Super cool. And this actually, this property and much of the west side was an ancient seabed. And so I've been listening to this book called Origins, which is just a little plug for the book, how the earth has shaped human history. And there's a really fascinating section about limestone. And anyways, it kind of referenced all the fossils that we find around here. So anyways, this property is mostly a limestone base, and we see white rocks everywhere. And we pulled lots of white rocks out of the slopes when we were preparing to plant. And what does that bring to the wine?
It brings minerality. It brings energy.
Because
personality.
Because our soil pHs are.
We have high alkaline soils.
So we have high acid wine, which is a really interesting relationship. Anyways, that's like a really positive thing. Oftentimes, people have a hard time with preserving the acid in their grapes throughout the growing season, but we don't have that issue. So it's really nice and contributes to the balance of these wines.
Yes. Nice to see Rhoda Wines in the house. Thanks for tuning in.
So,
a big fan of the MAHA Estate wines, as I have seen on your gram feed.
So, most of you know that Peachy Canyon Road is becoming quite the hot spot in Paso Robles.
It is the corridor if you're tasting on the west side.
We've got Torin.
Yes.
Making amazing, delicious Rhone varieties and also Pinot Noir and Chardonnay. We've got Via Creek. And then what's the next spot?
Might it be 6 Mile Bridge?
That's what it is.
6 Mile Bridge, just over the hill, looking to open here in the next, whenever we can be social again. Jim and Barbara Maroney doing some fantastic Bordeaux varieties, various blends on the reds, and then a Sauvignon Blanc on the white. And one of our favorite friends, two of them, Anthony and Hillary Yant. Hillary's taking care of the farming, so she's making Anthony look good while he makes the wine. So he doesn't have to do too much. Never really does, but... But Juan, you know that, right? Next wine.
So
yes,
we have a we are going to have a trivia question coming up in a little bit, and we're going to give away a bottle of Camille. What did I say? Understory, and but we're also going to give away a bottle of Six Mile Bridge. I'm not sure which wine yet, but.
I think we give away the Estate Cuvée, because that's my favorite.
Okay.
We're going to do that one.
And Jim and Barbara, I did clear this with rosemary, so.
Ooh, do you see that little heart? Look at those hearts, floating hearts. Cool. I like that. Oh, look at the roots wine, getting all fancy.
Anyways, Madame Rosemary is on the gram with us right now, and she's their tasting room manager and wine club manager, etc. And... Anyways, we're happy to have all of them in the neighborhood. It's super cool. Okay, and then we also have Law, and we have Calcareous, and it's just really an exceptional little stretch of road here in Paso. And we're not like that far away from each other. This is all within about a 5-mile stretch, so you have to drive all over town.
It was just a couple years ago that people didn't really think of the Peachy Corridor when they were going out tasting, but now with ourselves and our great neighbors, if you're coming to Paso and spending a day tasting on the west side, if you miss the Peachy Corridor, you have totally missed it. So pay attention. Do the Peachy Corridor. Joanne, what do you think of the backlit?
Well, let's see. I think the label's pretty cool.
So cool. That's cool. Tell us about the label.
Hey, so, Cody's in the house. Hey, Cody. We miss you.
Joanne does all of the labels for Via Creek and MAHA Estate. Can you give us a little bit of insight as to these labels?
Mm-hmm. You spit into my other glass. So, I paint with wax. That's my current medium. So, many of our current labels, or especially these one-offs, we call them, these are all done with wax. And so, it's called encaustics, for those of you who aren't familiar with the term. And it's an ancient medium. I think it's really cool. It's textural. I love the smell of the wax, and it's beeswax mixed with resin. So when I'm creating a label, we come up with the name first, and then I try to match the label to the name, obviously. And so Understory, I don't know. I think it kind of looks like a microbiota, like a little...
I don't know. Something looks like a bird turd splattered to me.
Well, there's lots of both of that.
This is a Rorschach test. What do you guys see? You tell us.
But
does anybody
see
a naked person?
I kind of see Bacchus.
I saw that. Bacchus? I see
like
that.
Lots of hair blowing in the wind. Anyways, this is the original piece. Looks nothing like this. It's this is something that. I always have to take the label, the art, and kind of morph it to fit on a wine label. But and then backlit is just a reference to the moon and the sun. Again, we farm biodynamically. Probably talk a little bit about that, because that's a very important part of what we do here. Cat paw.
Meow.
Interesting.
Meow.
I don't see it.
I saw it. Rose, I saw it. I mean, it's not like a cat paw that you might see on Tiger King, but... It's cat paw, nonetheless.
Peter, who walks the country, welcome to our tasting. We're not tasting any Via Creek wines today. definitely next week, next Friday. But these are MAHA estates, so these are all wines that we make, and MAHA is just our estate where we grow grapes. Some of the grapes go into the Via Creek wine, but we take our best barrels and put them into these MAHA estate, all estate wines. And so another really cool thing that you don't see often on premium wines is ingredients organic grapes. That's something that we're very proud to have for you all.
Yeah, I just did a Facebook Live with Niels Utzon of Castora Cellars and Neil Collins from Tablas Creek and Lo Madrone and Bristol Cellars with Chris Toronto from the Paso Robles Wine Country Alliance. And it was a conversation with regards to sustainable, organic, and biodynamic farming. And we had some great questions come in from folks, but, you know, we feel that we farm this way because we live this way, we eat this way, and people ask, why do you farm organically and biodynamically? And it's culturally, it's how we live. We think that it's the best long-term play. It makes the best grapes that in turn make great wines, but it'll make sure that we can provide life where we farm for generations moving forward. And Nils Utzon from Castoro quietly farms 1,500 acres of certified organic biodynamic fruit here in the Paso Robles Appalachian. So our hats are off to him. We only farm 13 acres. He's doing 1,500 acres. And when you look at some of the larger farming operations here in Paso and throughout the rest of California, you know, it's like you can't do it that way. But it really comes down to their commitment, Nils and Bimmer. It's a cultural component. They understand that they want to make sure that their employees and anybody that's on their property doesn't have to worry about anything. They don't have to wear a white suit or a respirator or anything like that. So Castoro, along with Tablas Creek, they're doing 150 acres. Adelaida Cellars getting ready to receive their organic certification. So the west side of Paso's got an opportunity to, our climate makes it a little less challenging to farm organically than some of the wetter climates. And there are lots of folks, peers of ours, that farm that way, and we hope that they'll certify, because it's just, it's for the greater good. Where are the dogs? There's one dog there, and there's one dog there. Obi.
They were up working and barking all night, so they're really tired today. We have sheep in the vineyard. Sheep are out here in the vineyard today, and so when that happens, the dogs are kind of roaming all night, protecting them. They're not in their pasture. When they're in their pasture, with sheep are in their pasture, it's a lot easier for our dogs. They're really tired. Hopefully somebody will come over and say hi.
So I can't see who asked what the drinking windows are for the MAHA estate wines. These wines were bottled last April. And what we've seen is in the last few months, they've really started to relax a little bit. I think they'll maintain their primary fruit component for 3 to 5 years and then evolve into a secondary, more tertiary component for fruit. So it really kind of depends on how you like to drink your wine. But I think these wines will cellar well. I would say 7 to 15 years pretty well. But once again, we really won't know until we get there. And one of my favorite sayings, I think Manfred Krankel was posed the question, how do you like your wines? And he said, well, when it comes to wine, I'm more of a pedophile than a necrophiliac. And everybody at the table were aged white wine. So we're all, you know.
I think they'll go longer than that, actually. We were just drinking today some 2010s from, actually a 2010 from Chateauneuf-du-Pape, the Chateau Saint-Jean. Deux Machina.
It was banging.
2010 that we bought when we were there, and
It was really good. If you have the 10 Saint Jean de Ex Machina, crack it. Delicious.
So I think Grenache definitely definitely can hang in the bottle for a while. Yeah. I think it just gets better. And also the Petit Sirah. So we're not jacking up our wines with a bunch of, you know, the winemaking is simple.
Yes.
I wish, are you wearing your I'm special shirt? But yeah, different.
See, I'm special. made different.
Anyways, you should, that's a cool shirt. You need to yes. Shine that off. Anyways, what was I saying?
I don't know.
Shoot.
Fuck. The challenges of a creative mind. Oh, Rhoda, you drinking 19 rosé right now? Strawberries and raspberries? Love it.
It's so good. Who saw Camille's video? We just sent an email out with Camille. Camille has a YouTube video tasting the 2019 rosé, and it's really good. We're getting our outdoor video skills down. Oftentimes the wind is blowing when we're doing these things, and so it's hard to do a nice recording. So we found a pretty sheltered spot here under our awning, which is nice. Anyways, we're getting that dialed in, but hopefully the wind isn't bothering anybody. So
it's not bothering me.
We have some more backlog.
We've got just a few minutes. Do any of you have any questions? I would say someone chimed in, asked me the other day, what's MAHA mean? Make America happy again? Damn straight. Of course it does. We're happy.
I'm really sad. Oh, I don't want to get into politics here, but Henry broke out, I think it was like 2014. I love the color red, and we made some Via Creek hats, bright red Via Creek hats, and they're super cool, and they say Via Creek. And then we had somebody who worked in politics here at the winery, and then our current president was elected, and then somehow all the red hats disappeared. I don't know where they went. But Henry broke one out the other day, and I was wearing it proudly, because I love red.
What? Hillary Yount, you can't be on Instagram right now. You just had a baby. For those of you that don't know Hillary Yount, she just had baby Loretta. I think baby Loretta came a week ago, Tuesday, 7 pounds, 12 ounces. Loretta came into this world at the Royal Nonsuch farm at home. And,
too.
That's awesome. So Joanne is a much stronger woman than I am, obviously. We had...
Wait, I thought I was the brains and you were the brawn.
No, I said stronger woman.
Okay.
You are the brains and I was the brawn. There's dog shit in it? No. Oh, that thing. What's that thing called?
Thought about that for the last half hour and so... I'm glad you didn't get up.
So the wines are available online. We have we held back a bit of inventory to be tasted and sold here at the tasting room. But with regard to this whole COVID thing, I am just shocked what the world will do to make their hair grow or their dick harder. I'm going to eat a bat or I'm going to eat a tiger testicle. For God's sakes, people, if it's not meant to eat, don't eat it. And look what it gets us. A world pandemic.
I don't know, but if in another another couple of months, we might have to resort to that, eating bats.
Well, my hair's not going to grow, and I don't know if my wiener's growing either. So.
Anyways, and on that note.
Thank you, Sean.
Thank you, everybody who's following the rules. I'm generally not a rule follower. Sorry, Mom and Dad and Aunt Joey.
Bullshit.
I saw that you're here. Anyways. I like to do things my own way. So anyways, but in this situation, I wear a mask when I go to the grocery store. And I think everybody should at this point in the game. And it's really disappointing to go out to certain stores in the North County.
Anywhere.
And see that the people that work there aren't masked or gloved or anything. And it just is disappointing.
Act positive, right? Act positive. What's the trivia question? Camille Cherry, thank you for bringing us back on target. We're 3 minutes over. All right, where's your phone, Joe? Where's your phone?
Oh, I'm going to show you the picture. So we have this block of grapes
behind us. The block of grapes behind us was the first block planted in 2012. It's 3+ acres of Grenache. It's a Garnacha clone. And it is fondly... Come on. Camille, where's the photo? It is fondly named after one of our animals. Okay, and
She is since deceased.
Deceased?
God rest her soul.
Moved on? Okay, so...
She's in a better place. Anyways.
Whoever can name that dog, what is the name of that dog, gets a bottle of Maha wine. Look at that dog.
And a bottle of Six Mile Bridge.
And a bottle of Six Mile Bridge. Look at the answers just pouring in. No, Spot's not it.
This is
Princess
her,
isn't it.
This is her block behind us.
Alan Hamill.
Sweet.
Way to go, Alan Hamill. Fanny, that's right.
Her name is Fanny.
Fanny was the best dog ever. Karen Royce, too slow. Laura Hartness, too slow. Amaro, too slow. Hillary, too slow. Alan Hamill, on it. Hey, Alan Hamill, what are you drinking right now? Because he drinks pretty well and he loves Paso. They love Paso.
Here we are. Okay, I'm showing you another picture.
Oh.
Of Fanny. This is up in block one, otherwise known as Fanny's block. We were working in the vineyard together one day. We have the same nose, by the way, in case you didn't notice.
Fanny has much better breath. So we're coming up on 5:36.
You should have named Loretta Fanny. It's not too late, Hillary.
So upon that, that's a brief bit of history on the Maha Estate and these wines that we thoroughly enjoy. Like we had mentioned before, these are trying times that are unique to all of us. So be safe, love one another. Shelter in place. We'll all get social physically. It's not the 80s or 70s or whatever. We'll all be back together in a more tactile, that's a wrong choice too, way in the future. Alan Hamill's drinking Linea Coloto Problem Child. I wonder if that...
2012.
Was Matt a problem child too?
I think Maureen named that wine out for Matt.
Got it. But that being said, be well, be safe, be happy. Please tune in to us on next Friday. And spread the word. If you're drinking Via Creek or Maha, throw it up on the socials. Throw it up on the gram. Throw it up on Facebook. We have a very small flock of folks. Most of you are here today. Thank you so much. But... we'll make sure that you maintain your allocations and get what you want, but we're always trying to switch people on to what we're doing out here. So you guys know, and you know it's that shampoo. They tell two friends, and so on, and so on, and so on. So all of you have a wonderful weekend. Thank you so much for showing up. Joe?
Oh, cheers. Wash your hands. Don't touch your face. And have a great, great weekend.
Cheers. Thanks so much. We're going to put the tunes back on Spotify Maha Wines. We'll send an email out. And
we will have merch, Laura Hartness. Merch on the website. You'll all get an email. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thanks.